Kids, when did you realize your parents might be terminally stupid? I asked my mom for Super Mario All-Stars on the Super Nintendo for my 8th or 9th birthday. She had no idea what I was talking about, so I explained what the game was. For those who may not know, it had all the original NES Mario games, Super Mario World, and one other Mario game that I think was previously unreleased. The SNES was still new, so games were expensive. But that was literally all I had asked for, so I was fairly confident. A couple of weeks went by and I didn't really think much about it. On my birthday, I came home from school to a big wrapped box, much bigger than the game. I tore into it and opened up the box to find an old Nintendo. Next to it were cartridges for the first three Mario games. I was so confused. Mom, it's exactly what you wanted me. It is mom, yes. I took your Super Nintendo into the swap meet and traded it in for the games that you wanted. It's been over 20 years and she hasn't gotten any better. Edit. Thank you, kind stranger. Finally, a story I can tell. Every Friday my mother goes grocery shopping. It's a block away and she usually drives there. On this particular day, after she finished shopping, she decides to walk back. The next morning she wakes me and my father up to let us know her car was stolen. Cops come, we fill out paperwork, and in the meanwhile she gets a rental car. That's not even the best part. The following Friday she drives again to the grocery market and parks right next to her stolen car, which is a champagne colored Mitsubishi Diamante, not such a common car color. She comments how similar the car looks like hers but makes nothing of it. A few days later the cops call us to let us know the car is in the grocery store's parking lot one block away. Yay. I got plenty of other stories, but that's probably the best one. When I was in 4th grade, my mother insisted helping with my homework for some reason. I was always a smart kid. I never needed help, but she forced me to let her help. She proceeded to redo my math and spelling homework and I failed both assignments. I told her those answers were wrong and she fought me on it. When I got to school I cried and told the teacher my mom made me put wrong answers, and I told her I knew the right ones but my mom forced me to let her help. The teacher laughed, took my paper and asked me the questions after I got to write. Immediately she marked everything on the page wrong and gave it back to me. She told me not to worry, she put 100% in the grade book, she just wanted me to show that one to my mom. Not my parents. But one of my dad's cousins was talking to us about how her daughter and her son-in-law were having a baby, but that she was worried about it because the son-in-law is deaf and she was concerned their child would be deaf too. The conversation continued and she then disclosed that the son-in-law is deaf because of a head injury from a bad car accident he was in when he was a teenager. My dad, who is a doctor, kept trying to reassure her that this was not possible, but she basically thought that you pass on to your kids whatever physical attributes your body has at the time you conceive them, regardless of how your body got that way. My mom broke into my dad's house with a gun. Pooped her pants while in the house and left the pants on the stairs. My dad is anti-vax and a flat earther. He thinks he's very smart, good example of Dunning-Kruger effect. He's also very stubborn. He got into an argument with my brother and I about whether it was possible for us to travel faster than the speed of light and other physics stuff. His reasoning was they did it in Star Trek, it can happen in real life, not joking, either. My dad crashed his car at 8 a.m, on his way to work, because he was surprised at a naked woman streaking across the road. When the police turned up and asked what happened, he explained that he ended up crashing as he wasn't sure if he really just saw a naked woman, or if he was still drunk from the night before. And that is how he lost his driver's license, because oddly enough, there was a naked woman, and he was still drunk. Stepdad sees one of those tearjerker commercials about starving children in Africa, proceeds to rant about how there's plenty of animals to hunt in Africa and why don't they just eat. Literally shouting at the TV, eat. Just eat. In high school, grades were posted online. Dad wanted to check how poorly I was doing. I told him the internet is closed because it was after 5 p.m. When my mom said she just couldn't figure out why my aunt didn't like her after my mom borrowed $100 from her to buy us food and spent it on cigarettes and beer, stole another $20 from her to buy a DVD, and then hit my dad in the face with a frying pan. If your 6-year-old can figure it why and you can't, then maybe you're incurable stupid. My dad doesn't believe in carbon monoxide poisoning. My mom can't use the decimal point on a calculator. Edit. Dad thinks carbon monoxide is a scam to sell detectors and appliances. I rented a place from my parents that had an old heater and it leaked the first time I used it. My roommates and I woke up feeling horrible. By sheer luck, I realized what it was. The fire department had to threaten my dad to get him to fix the problem. Mom likes to do the calculator thing her way, if you ask why. I think she gets confused when the last zero disappears. But math without it is actually worse, obviously, and some of my most vivid childhood memories are her screaming at people on the phone because her numbers didn't match her balance. It was a monthly thing. Edit 2. Today, my mom asked me how much a gram weighs. Years ago I was building a potato cannon, which my father was uninterested in thinking it was just stupid, until he saw me working on it in the garage. I have the cannon in the vise and had just put in an electronic barbecue igniter and wired it to some bolts inside to get a good spark. Suddenly he's very interested. I had just managed to get a perfect gap with a strong arc and he says wait, let go of the button for a second and sprays quick start, basically aerosol ever, and goes okay, hit it now, nothing happened. Both ends of the cannon are open so it's just a tube and the quick start he sprayed just dissipated too quick. Okay, hold the button for a sec, I'm not even thinking about what he's about to do at this moment, and he aims the spray right at the live arc and created a fireball that came straight for his face, singeing his one eyebrow and corner of his mustache. I can't imagine what he thought was going to happen. When they gave my college fund to a preacher so he could send Bibles to Nicaragua. My parents got hit by the second Microsoft tech support scam this week. My dad insists MLMs are worthy investments and genuinely believes the whole family has especially. When she was fully convinced that the country of Mexico was made the 51st state of the USA in the 60s. No, she was not confusing New Mexico and Mexico. When faced with reality, she said that it was a widely taught fact when she went to school in the 70s. Edit, let me clarify that she was 100% lying about being taught this in school and later admitted to it when called out by her sister. My mom asked whether World War I or II came first. My parents made me take piano lessons since I was 9. When I told them I wanted to be a professional pianist, they were ashamed. My mom got mad at me for getting a flu shot. Because the government uses them to track and poison people. I was 30 at the time. Are well educated, but this was one of the stupidest things I've seen them do. I was in the basement playing video games and went upstairs to my parents frantically looking for me. They were in that anger relief kind of state and told me they'd been looking for me 4 hours and were about to call the cops. Here's the thing. I had my phone on me the entire time, and had received no calls, text messages from either of them. Also, none of them ever went down to the basement to check if I was there, otherwise they would have seen me. I couldn't have really left the house either, cause I wasn't old enough to drive at the time. I don't know what was going through their minds but it definitely wasn't common sense. I would have loved to see the police officer's face if they found me in the basement after they called the cops. Edit, I made the point about not being old enough to drive because there was nothing appealing about walking outside randomly for a 15-year-old. Also, if I'm in my basement playing video games for hours on end, I'm pretty sure it's obvious that I didn't go outside often. Edit 2. I can't discount my dad not smoking pot, but my mom is oblivious. She seriously thought that the weed a student smelled like was just bad BO. Also, I unfortunately know that they don't have sex outside their room. My mom wanted to drive to the new Google office building to complain about her Yahoo email account. I barely managed to convince her that they are different companies. Edit, thanks for the upvotes, comments and amp, silver. My mom is very smart but lacks common sense. I spend most of my time trying to convince her not to do stupid things. Perhaps I should just let her do it, and film it. Dad introduces me to someone I've never met. Dad, do you recognize this person? Me, 24 years old, no. Dad, but she held you when you were a baby. When my mom heard that drinking a glass of red wine a day is good for you, she poured my dad a full pint glass of red wine, and he downed it. When I asked them what made them think that was an appropriate amount, they replied that's how much alcohol people drink in the movies.